Go left. Go. 5 minutes out.
Are we actually recording this?
Yeah, we are.
Think there might be another way. Just feel better about today. Oh no, if you never want to have to turn and go away, you might feel better if you stay. Yeah, yeah, I bet you haven't heard a word I've said. Yeah, yeah, you've had enough of all you're trying. Just give up the state of mind you're in. If you wanna be somebody else, if you're tired of fighting battles with yourself, if you wanna be somebody else, change your mind. Change your
Good morning, Phoenix High School. I'm Albert Funes.
And I'm Corey Romig. We've got a few announcements, so let's get into it.
Wait, I have something really important to say. The third quarter is almost over, so we have a segment all about it.
Students, you have 2 weeks till the end of the quarter. Now is the time. Students, you have 2 weeks till the end of the quarter. Now is the time to get everything together and not at the last minute. April 14th is the last day before the official end of the quarter. Don't make Mr. Rhodes annoyed by coming in during in-service day. Seriously.
The Spanish proficiency testing will take place April 7th. This opportunity is for all junior and senior native speakers of Spanish to earn up to 4 years of credit. Please see sign-up sheets in Ms. Hansen or Ms. Sievert's room. Once a year, this test is given. There are no makeup days, no exceptions. If you have any questions, see me, Sievert.
Just a reminder, Relay for Life is still meeting on Thursdays at lunch in Ms. Barton's room, N412.
On another note, announcements for the National Honor Society will be posted in Mr. Cornett's room, N206. Also, the Alexandra Hanscom Scholarship is now available to apply for. You have to be a senior female three sport athlete who has participated in OSAA school sports. Your first 3 years, you need to play three sports, and your last year, only two. If you're interested or have questions, please see the Future Planning Center or Lona Engel for information.
Many students haven't realized that we have had a class called Emergency Care and Prevention. This class gives you an opportunity to achieve a first aid and CPR card.
We have a segment explaining this awesome class.
What is emergency care and prevention?
So emergency care and prevention is a class that we offer as part of our health occupations courses. And it offers a lot of hands-on activities for students while teaching them a little bit about different aspects of the healthcare field. Types of things that students do and learn is first aid and CPR. So we get hands-on with the mannequins, learn lots of different techniques about that. How to manage sports injuries. Fire suppression and prevention. So we actually get the fire department here on campus and students get to practice putting out fires with real extinguishers. We do basic search and rescue. So a little bit about if you had to extract a victim from a building, whether there had been a fire, an earthquake, anything like that, how to get those victims out, how to carry them safely. And then patient triaging. So if a big accident happened, we had a mass casualty situation, how do we choose who is most severely hurt, needs help, to the least severely hurt that needs help? So categorizing them. So a lot of hands-on activities in this class. Anybody that has any sort of interest in healthcare someday will be benefited by this class. So if you have any interest in working in a hospital or being an EMT, anything like that, it's perfect. So even if you don't know if you want to work in healthcare, but you plan to get a job someday where first aid and CPR is required, this is your opportunity to get a certification card. So a lot of different opportunities for you that will help you later down the road.
Emily's Fun Center and is in the planning stages, and we need your help from parents to make it happen. The meetings are every Thursday at 6:30 in the PHS library. It's not necessary to come to every meeting, but even the smallest contributions help. For participating in the help, you could win a Bose stereo, flat screen TV, and even a kayak. A recruiter from Linfield College will be visiting Phoenix High School next Monday during sixth period. Linfield College is a small private college located in McMinnville and is well known for its arts and nursing programs. If you are interested in learning more about the school, please sign up in the Future Planning Center.
On Tuesday, April 12th, during third period, a representative from RCC will be here to talk about the Southern Oregon Hope Program. This is a new program for students looking for careers in a medical field and may cover the cost of tuition and supplies to qualified students. Want to learn more? Please sign up at the Future Planning Center. Great news, Phoenix. During the first month of the third quarter, we had a 62% decrease in the number of students with more than 10 tardies, a 29% decrease in the number of students with between 4 and 10 tardies, a 39% decrease in the total number of unexcused absences. Keep up the good work with being a class that regularly attends the race record time.
Prom is coming up fast, but it seems you don't have to. But it seems you don't have a prom dress. No need to worry. Miss Campbell may have what you need. If you'd like to see what she has, see her in the classroom and at break, lunch, or right after school any day this week.
Go.
1 in 9 people worldwide do not have access to safe and clean drinking water. Around 80% of illnesses are linked to poor water and sanitation conditions, which is why Bernice and Gladys senior projects. They have decided to raise money to help provide a community in Africa with clean water through an organization called the Water Project. Here's a way you and your advisory class can help.
There will be an advisor competition at the front of every advisor's class. There will be water bottles where each class can donate money to this organization. The top two classes that donate the most amount of money will receive a donut party on April 18th. This competition will start today and end April 15th, so drop your change to make a change.
In sports news, the PHS baseball team lost in a hard-fought battle against South Umpqua with a score of 8-13. And against Cascade Christian on Friday, they swept the winning both contests by scoring 12-2 and 18-7.
Our softball team also lost against South Umpqua in a doubleheader with the scores of 4-14 and 5-21. And against Cascade Christian, almost pulled out the win, but just fell short by falling by a score of 4-3.
Phoenix High School competed in a OSAA district qualifying tournament and will be sending the following students to compete in this year's state championship at Western Oregon University. Noah Thompson placed first in Lincoln Douglas debate and third in impromptu. Joda Leiden placed third in Lincoln Douglas debate. Dave Teague and Jonathan Knowles placed third in parliamentary debate. Evan Schweikart and Nicoletta Danelli placed fourth in parliamentary debate and will be serving as alternates, while Evan Schweikart placed second in their impromptu.
I think it's time for some trivia. Last show's question, where did Dorian and Colton go in the fun spring break video? The winner is Cancun, Sweet Jesse D. Congratulations.
Get your reward at Mr. Rhodes' room N206A. This week's question is, what was the overall percentage decrease in the total number of unexcused absences in PHS since first semester? Turn your answer in the Manila folder at Rhodes' door.
As always, this has been your school,
your people,
and your news. As always, is missing there.